Jay Jayalalitha, Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, facing charges in two cases, one relating to non-filing of income tax returns and another of accumulation of disproportionate assets pending for over 15 years. A. Raja, one of the DMK's candidates for the Lok Sabha election, undergoing trial in the 2G Spectrum case and facing corruption charges for over 3 years. Dayanidhi Maran, also a DMK candidate for the general elections, facing corruption charges in the Airtel Maxis deal for close to 2 years. YSR Congress Chief Jagan Mohan Reddy, facing the charge of disproportionate assets for over 3 years. B.S. Yedurappa, BJP's Lok Sabha candidate from Shimoga, facing charges in corruption cases since early 2011. These are some of the political leaders who are facing the heat after the Supreme Court order issued on Monday aimed at decriminalizing electoral politics. The Supreme Court has directed trial courts to conclude trial of accused lawmakers within 1 year of the date of framing of charges against them for offences under the Representation of People's Act, failing which the trial court has to submit a report to the Chief Justice of the High Court concerned, apprising the court of the special reasons for the delay, after which the Chief Justice will need to issue appropriate directions to the court concerned for expediting the trial. The Apex Court has also directed the trial courts to hold hearings on a daily basis in such cases. The top court's order came on a petition filed by an NGO, Public Interest Foundation. The court pointed out that criminal cases against politicians drag on in courts for years and the accused politicians exploit the delay to preempt their disqualification from fighting elections. The need to cleanse the political system of criminal elements is also underscored in a report released by the Association for Democratic Reforms. According to the report, 1460 MPs and MLAs have pending criminal cases against them, including 162 MPs. 76 MPs face charges that entail a minimum punishment of 5 years in jail. 38 Rajya Sabha MPs have criminal cases pending against them, and 30% state legislators face charges that entail a minimum punishment of 5 years. For the record, most political parties have welcomed the Supreme Court order.
I think Supreme Court has struck a balance. Merely on the framing of the charge, there is no presumption of guilt, and therefore a person cannot be prevented from contesting elections. At the same time, nobody has a right to delay a trial.
If the one-year rule can be implemented on the ground and ensured, it is something which will be not only remarkable and laudatory, but something which the Congress party wholeheartedly welcomes.
When the Indian democracy and political system is facing deep-rooted crisis and the shadow of the criminals and unscrupulous elements, the anti-social elements has taken over the political process of this country, but the money power and mafia power is playing a role. At this point of time, the judgment of Supreme Court is a very, very positive development.
The Supreme Court judgment of July 2013, under which lawmakers are disqualified from office upon conviction in a criminal offence entailing punishment of over 2 years in jail, and Monday's order may go a long way in cleaning electoral politics. Bureau Report, DG News.